Hey everyone, it's Kevin. Welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'll walk through how to achieve these bright glow effects with Grease Pencil in Blender 3D. This is a question I get asked pretty frequently, so I thought I'd do a quick tutorial featuring this pumpkin candelabra, focusing specifically on the Grease Pencil flames. If you're not familiar with Grease Pencil, it's an object in Blender that allows you to draw and animate directly in 3D space. Grease Pencil has been a staple in my workflow because I enjoy incorporating it with 3D elements to create a sense of depth in my illustrations, and being a tool within Blender makes it incredibly versatile and multifunctional. For this tutorial, I'll be using Blender 4.2. I'll also have this file available as a free download on my Gumroad. There will be a before and after. If you're curious about the shading node setup on the meshes, you can find that in the files as well. Here, I have the before file open in Blender with the viewport shading set to material preview. The candelabra looks pretty dark and our goal is to lighten it. The first thing we'll need to do is adjust the viewport shading. Going up to the drop-down menu here, under Lighting, toggle on Scene Lights and Scene World. By default, any new file will have these two options toggled off under Material Preview. Since Grease Pencil elements can be affected by lights in a scene, it's important to turn them on to see what we're working with. We can now see the purple background, but our Grease Pencil elements, specifically the flames, appear darker. The layers in a Grease Pencil object have an option called Use Lights, which determines if that specific layer will be affected by lights in the scene. Since Use Lights is already toggled on for the elements we want to affect, they appear darker because we don't have any light sources yet. Now, I want the flames to reflect the original colors I chose. You can see this more accurately when I switch over to solid mode. One parameter that affects this is the viewport display color under the World Properties tab. To demonstrate this more clearly, I'll bring in a Grease Pencil monkey. Here, it appears dark, but if I lighten the viewport display color, it'll be more accurate according to the original colors while still being affected by lights in the scene. I can also change the hue of the display color and the Grease Pencil elements will adjust accordingly. I'll keep it set to white. Now we can add some lights. If you've seen any of my shading videos, you'll know that the toon shader on these meshes can be affected by lights in the scene as well. So I'll bring in a point light to create a general light source for this object. I'll set it to 1000 watts and place it somewhere in front of the object. Then you'll see it affect the object and Grease Pencil elements. Next, I'll start by lighting the face. I'll duplicate this light source and move it closer to the pumpkin. I'll lower the wattage to 200 and set it to a warm hue to reflect flames inside. I'll duplicate it two more times for the nose and mouth. For the flames, let's add some Grease Pencil visual effects. I'll select one of the flames and go to the Visual Effects tab. I'll add a glow effect, setting the opacity to 0.75, samples to 16, and checking glow under. Then I'll add a rim effect, set to an orange hue. I'll set the X offset to negative 12 and the Y offset to 0. After that, I'll copy these settings over to the other two flames by shift selecting them, then selecting the one with the effects, and hitting Ctrl L to copy Grease Pencil effects. Now, it may not look like anything has changed, and that's because we need to switch the viewport shading to render preview in order to see the effects. To intensify this, I'm going to duplicate one of the light sources in the front of the face and place one in front of each candle. Alright, almost done. The last step is to use compositing to enhance these effects. Previously, I would check bloom under the Render Properties tab, but in Blender 4.2, this option has moved to the compositing tab. I'm going to change the timeline view at the bottom to the compositor. In the viewport shading dropdown, set the compositor to always so we can see our changes as we make them. In the compositor, check use nodes and bring in a glare node. Set it to bloom, adjust the quality to high, set the threshold to 5, and the size to 9. To take this setup further, duplicate the glare node and set it to streaks. Connect the image output to it and set the following parameters: quality to high, iterations to 5, threshold to 3, angle offset to 45, and fade to 0.95. Next, go back to the bloom node and set the mix value to 1. Then bring in a mix color node. Set it to add and connect it accordingly. Then lower the factor value to refine the effect. To control the bloom even further, I'll add a blur node, setting both the X and Y values to 25. Finally, duplicate the mix color node. Set it to screen and connect it accordingly. Lower the factor value as needed to get the desired look. You might need to do some adjusting to make sure it's not overblown, like moving the light sources. But that's roughly how I achieve bright glow effects with grease pencil. And that's it for the tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks again, and see you all in the next video. Thank you.